Today we are taking a look at Lenovo Yoga 910. It is their newest in their Yoga line of high mobility devices that can be used on the road, as a tablet, or as a laptop. But does it impress or does it leave us stale as did the Lenovo Yoga Book? Stick around and find out. Starting with the specs, the Yoga is powered by 2.7 GHz Intel Core i7-7500U, a 2-core with hyper-threading that we are not really sure fully deserves the i7 tag, as we would have demanded better performance from it, but still, it's relatively high performance for everyday use. Our review unit had 16GB of DDR4 RAM, as well as 256GB of PCIe SSD, so high performance read and writes across the board with over 1GB per second reads. Given the small form factor, the graphics cards can't be expected to be anything special. Inside we can find the Intel HD Graphics 620 that does its job adequately. Aside from that, we have 802.11ac wireless with Bluetooth 4.1 and so on and so on. The specs inside aren't really the most important thing when you think about the Yoga line. It has to be mobile, usable and look good, of course, as it's meant for the lifestyle consumers, not the professional ThinkPad users. In line with that, on the 910 we get the stunning Infinity Edge-like display similar to Dell's that has almost no border around it and features a 4K IPS panel, so a 13.9-inch screen in a 12-inch form factor. Quite impressive. While on the topic of the monitor, we have to complain a bit regarding the large bottom bezel that also includes the webcam that subsequently has a really weird angle to it when using it for any sort of video calling, but I digress. The border bezel would have been better served to be a larger monitor, maybe a 16:10 aspect ratio or a 4:3, but then again, this product isn't the Lenovo Yoga 999, so there's still some more revisions to see. As far as connectivity goes, it has 3 USB ports, 2 standard USB Type-A, 1 USB 2.0 and 1 USB 3.1 Gen 1, while there's also another USB Type-C connector that enables monitor output. Sadly, there is no Thunderbolt 3 included in the product. And one other thing to note is the power in connector was replaced to the connector that is used with the USB Type-C for power in that wobbled around too much for our taste even after a few days of use, so I don't really know how the longevity of the product will be in the future. I would have definitely liked to see a MagSafe type charger that Apple has included with their MacBooks. Well, not anymore, but you get the point. Moving onwards to the touchpad and keyboard. When first starting to type on the 910, I got the feeling that the key presses were a little bit shallow on the keyboard itself, with a travel distance of 1.3 millimeters, but that is balanced out with the relatively stiff 65 grams of actuation force required for them to press it. After a few minutes of the initial weird feeling, we were quite used to the product and typing away with our full speed. Another thing to note about the layout is the weird software implementation of the shortcuts on the keyboard itself. For some you have to use the Windows button, for others the FM button, and some don't work at all. Maybe that's just on our review unit, but that was definitely something that bugged me quite a bit. Additionally, the layout could have been better, with the right shift being squeezed in at the arrow buttons is quite unorthodox to say the least. The touchpad satisfied our expectations, as it offered all the performance we wanted from it and never stuttered. It just kept on working, as all trackpads should. Maybe in the future we can look forward to the implementation that Apple has with their vibration instead of the actual click that feels just that tiny bit more premium. But hey, as said before, this is revision 910. But all isn't so well when it comes to audio. It's fine, but it could be better. You can hear everything, but the two bottom-mounted JBL speakers lack any sort of bass and depth to its sound that just sounds tinny, if you will. Some of the sound was rescued with Dolby's digital processing that maybe widened the soundstage a bit, but it didn't do much. On the other hand, what did impress us was the battery life. When continuously web surfing over Wi-Fi with a medium screen brightness that is completely satisfactory in normal conditions with 292 nits of brightness, it lasted over 10 hours and a half, and all that battery life is stuck in a product that weighs only 1.5 kilos. Moving to the most subjective part of the review, our feel of the device and the design of the unit itself. From the outside, it doesn't look that much different from the Yoga Book we have reviewed before, or from the last year's Yoga for that matter. But that isn't a bad thing. It has smooth, brushed aluminum metal panels on the top and bottom, shiny polished metal sides, and of course, Lenovo's signature watch band hinge that holds everything together in a sleek and thin looking package. It's a classy premium look. The only thing that stuck out quite literally for us were the metal edges that, when typing really furiously on the keyboard, got some marks on our wrists as they are quite sharp. But your experience may vary if you aren't quite as strong-armed about your PC usage as we are. To recap, the Lenovo Yoga 910 is quite possibly in the top of the 2-in-1 laptop market segment that is dominated by Lenovo, of course, with the Spectre X360 and the Dell's XPS line. In the end, it gives you the latest Intel Core i7 that is admittedly a dual core, but still fairly performance-minded, that power you through light Premiere Pro editing or Photoshop editing for photographers among you. It has a 13.9-inch screen in a compact body that delivers more than 10 hours of battery life with standard use and around 6 or 7 when pushing the internals. To add to that, the best hinge on the market today and a quite affordable starting price. The only real downside is the lack of a SIM card slot for creative professionals, wobbly power connector, unimpressive audio, and the quite large bottom bezel. And while it may seem as that is quite a big list of things we don't like on the product, if you were to put in words everything we do appreciate about the performance, about the usability and design of the 910, this would have been a 25-minute video, not a 6-minute one as it is now. If you're a creative professional, I wouldn't recommend this product to you, but would recommend the newly announced Yoga 720 or something of the like. But if you want a premium-looking laptop that won't slow you down in offices or in lecture rooms or whatnot, the Yoga 910 is a solid purchase.